Well, we now have over 20 years of experience with research and practice with integrated behavioral health care. There are now over 70 research studies that have been done in this area. And if you look at the key message that comes from this body of research, it's really three things. If you have primary care providers, primary care physicians, and mental health professionals collaborate closely, work closely together, caring for a patient, there are three things that come from that. First of all, you get a much better patient care experience. Second of all, you have better health outcomes, and that's not just physical health outcomes, but also mental health outcomes and better functioning in general. And then you also have lower healthcare costs. When you provide this kind of care in an integrated way, it actually leads to a reduction in overall healthcare costs. And today, that is called the triple aim: better patient care experience, better health outcomes, and lower healthcare costs. Well, if there is one thing we have learned from research on integrated care that's also tremendously important for every practitioner, every practice is trying to implement an effective, evidence-based integrated care program, then it is the idea of keeping your eye on the prize. That's also something we now call measurement-based practice. So the idea there is that just like with high blood pressure, where every time that you come into the doctor's office, somebody will measure your blood pressure and sees your treatment on the right track, we have to do the exact same thing when we're treating things like depression or anxiety. Now, that's easier said than done, but it's actually quite easy to do. It can take a simple 9-item rating scale that the patient fills out to see how bad their depression is doing or how much they're progressing in their treatment, and that can be done in a couple minutes in the doctor's office, or it can be done at home before coming in to see the doctor. And with that information, we then can see, is the treatment working? And what we'll discover is about half the time, the treatment is actually quite effective, and about half the time, it's not quite working yet. And that doesn't mean that we have a bad patient or a bad provider, it's just not quite the right treatment. And that means we then have to make a change in treatment. We might have to get a consultation with another specialist, but it really is important to have that information every time we see the patient to see, are we on the right track? Can we make changes? So ultimately, we can really get the vast majority of our patients in a primary care setting better.